sbs.com.au/khmer
ការចេះនឹងនិយាយភាសាអង់គ្លេសអាចជួយឲ្យជីវិតរបស់អ្នកប្រសើរឡើងនៅក្នុងប្រទេសអូស្ត្រាលីនៅក្នុងវគ្គនីមួយៗយើងនឹងពន្យល់អំពីការរស់នៅនិងសំនួនវោហាររបស់ប្រជាជនអូស្ត្រាលីអ្នកនឹងបង្កើនជំនាញភាសាអង់គ្លេសរបស់អ្នកសិក្សាអំពីប្រទេសអូស្ត្រាលីនិងទទួលបាននូវភាពសប្បាយរីករាយក្នុងពេលតែមួយត្រៀមហើយឬនៅ
Learning English helped me to enjoy a barbecue with friends.
SBS acknowledges the traditional custodians of country and their connections and continuous care for the skies, lands and waterways throughout Australia.
When I bite into a perfectly barbecued prawn, the taste, well, it brings a smile to my face. Whether it's on a beach, in a park, or in someone's backyard, a barbecue with its friendly, relaxed atmosphere has become one of my favorite ways to spend time with my friends. My name is Josipa, and since moving to the land down under, I've been to countless Barbies. A Barbie is a short Australian word for barbecue. Just like arvo is a short way of saying afternoon. These two words form the phrase I love to use. Let's have a Barbie this arvo. There's no denying it. Aussies know how to do Barbies right. It's basically the taste of Australian culture. That's what my friends Alan and Claire say. And let me tell you, they throw some of the best Barbies ever. Yes, you can throw a Barbie just like you can throw a party. Funny language English, isn't it? Well, today, I'm carefully bringing over a pav, that's a short for pavlova, one of my favorite desserts, to Alan's backyard. Children are racing around, and Alan and Claire are cooking over the fire. Yes. The smoke is adding a great, inviting smell to the party atmosphere. Come on, what are you waiting for? Let's get a little bit closer.
We need to give everything a little longer, don't we?
Yeah, nah, the chooks look done, I reckon. You can take it off. Pass me the tongs, will ya? I need to flip these steaks.
Here you go. Oh, I'll grab the prawns from the esky. Do you want the onions on now too?
Yeah, chuck them on.
Coming right up. Oh, let's throw some extra snags on. I'll bet you the kids will ask for a second round.
You're probably right. There's Josipa with the pat. This is going to be a ripper Barbie.
I'm so hungry after listening to this dialogue. But before I can eat the leftovers from this amazing Barbie, we have some work to do. By the way, leftovers are the food that is left after a meal. For example, if you have extra food after your dinner, you can have leftovers the next day for lunch. I do that all the time. Now let's get to work. Claire thinks that everything on the Barbie still needs a little more cooking, but Alan disagrees. He said,
Yeah, nah, the chooks look done, I reckon.
I reckon is an informal way of saying I think. And Alan doesn't think that the chook needs more cooking, so he disagrees with Claire. In Australian English, we can use the phrase, yeah, nah, to start off when you don't agree with someone, but you want to be friendly and informal. For example, if Alan asks Claire to turn off the barbecue, but she doesn't think they have finished cooking, she can say,
yeah, nah, I don't think that's a good idea.
And do you know what a chook is? In Aussie slang, chook means chicken. Alan said the chook, the chicken, looks done. When food looks done, it looks as if it is cooked.
Pass me the tongs. I need to flip these steaks.
Alan is asking for the tongs, a tool used for picking up and turning food. And if you need to flip your food, it means you have to turn it over while it's cooking. Claire passed him the tongs and said,
I'll grab the prawns from the esky. Do you want the onions on now too?
Claire is going to get the prawns from the esky. This is an Australian word for a cooler or icebox that keeps food and drinks cold. She asked Alan if he wants the onions too. Do you remember his reply? He said,
yeah, chuck them on.
Chuck them on is an informal way to say put them on. It's a useful phrase when it comes to adding more food, but you can use it in other situations as well. Let's say you're putting together a playlist for your family road trip and your son wants to add more songs. You could say,
yeah, chuck them on.
Let's continue.
Coming right up, let's throw some extra snags on. I'll bet you the kids will ask for a second round.
Coming right up. We can use this phrase when we are just starting to do something that someone has asked us to do or is expecting us to do. Claire also said,
let's throw some extra snags on. I'll bet you the kids will ask for a second round.
To throw something extra on means to add it. Claire wants to throw some extra snags on. A snag is Australian slang for a sausage. So Claire wants to throw some extra snags on Barbie because she thinks the kids will ask for a second round. That is, another helping or portion. We can use this phrase to talk about having more food or drink. And also when we are playing games with other people. So we can talk about another round of cards, for example, if we would like to play again. At Barbie's, I always go for a second round of prawns. At the end of our dialogue, Alan said,
this is going to be a ripper, Barbie.
Ripper means great or fantastic in Australian slang. So Alan is saying that he thinks this barbecue is going to be great. And it really was. Now, let's listen to the dialogue once again. Actually, while you listen to Alan and Claire again, I'll enjoy the leftovers. Yummy!
We need to give everything a little longer, don't we?
Yeah, nah, the chooks look done, I reckon. You can take it off. Pass me the tongs, will ya? I need to flip these steaks.
Here you go. Oh, I'll grab the prawns from the esky. Do you want the onions on now too?
Yeah, chuck them on.
Coming right up. Oh, let's throw some extra snags on. I'll bet you the kids will ask for a second round.
You're probably right. There's Josefa with the pat. This is going to be a ripper, Barbie.
My guest today is a very talented producer whom listeners of SBS Cantonese might recognize. Gloria is also a big fan of Aussie barbecues, and apparently she's very good at it. Isn't that right, Gloria?
Yes, there was this one time when I was with my uni friends and I was the designated like sausage tongs chef.
So you were flipping sausages all day?
Yeah, that's what I did mainly, and everyone was happy with it. Yay!
Yay! Well, the main reason I invited you today is because you have started working with Learn English. But before we get into that, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, sure. So, hello, my name is Gloria, and I am usually with the SBS Cantonese team. And so I'm from Hong Kong originally, and I study journalism and philosophy. And I've been in Australia for 5 years now.
I'm going to visit my family in Croatia and I will be away for 1 month. While I'm away, you'll be producing episodes for my podcast and thank you so much for that. I know that you're already working on your first episode. Can you tell us what it is about?
Yes, so stay tuned, everyone. The topic will be about being scammed. Let's learn how to talk about being scammed.
Oh, that's super useful and interesting. I can't wait to hear it. But now, can you help us practice the phrases from this episode?
Yeah, sure.
It's time to practice. See if you remember the meaning before hearing the answer. The phrase, let's have a Barbie this Arvo, means,
Let's have a barbie this arvo is a casual way of saying let's have a barbecue this afternoon.
What is an esky?
An esky is an Australian word for a cooler or icebox that keeps food and drinks cold.
Let's now practice our speaking skills by repeating after Alan and Claire.
The chook looks done.
Pass me the tongs.
I need to flip these steaks.
I'll grab the prawns from the esky.
For more practice, visit our website sbs.com.au/learnenglish. You can also find us on Facebook and YouTube. We are SBS Learn English. I'm Josipa. Thank you for learning Australian English with me.
ចូលចិត្តអ្វីដែលអ្នកស្ដាប់នេះទេ? Subscribe SBS Khmer នៅលើ Podcast Player ដែលលោកអ្នកចូលចិត្ត។